that I had left to give. All the reasons I confirmed. You're my reason left to live. If that ain't enough, oh no, no, tell me why it's not enough. Hey, even when you let me down, I forgive you in the end. What goes round comes back around, so I'll wait for you till then. If that's not enough,
Redskins coming up on EA Sports Week 2, football on tap as we get set for today's game.
Well, Phil, we've got a terrific matchup at running back. Two of the most dangerous backs in the NFL about to meet, go toe-to-toe. How do you see it?
Well, you know what? It's not always about the quarterback when you talk about NFL games. And here's a great example of it today. The game of football is still about the most physical team wins. And when you have running backs like this, the more physical team will win.
This game is underway. There is a flag out. Foster's lined up as the single back. First down at the 40. To the outside, Foster. And that's a gain of 13.
The big smooth, that's Arian Foster. He makes it look so easy. He goes outside off tackle, and he can cover a lot of yards with those strides, and he gets a first down on that run.
First and 10. Handoff made. Tackle by David Hawthorne. Here's a look at the Redskins lineup on offense. They posted over 500 yards passing last week, so their confidence should be sky high. Second and 6. The catch is made by Witten. Witten's taken down at the 25.
That's a good job by the receiver, running the drag route across the field. These are not easy throws for the quarterback, but he sticks it right on him for the completion.
Playing press coverage to the outside. The Redskins approach the line, and they're going with their jumbo package. And the flag comes out. That penalty is, of course, going to be accepted by the defense. Breaking huddle at the 35-yard line. Foster takes his spot in the backfield. The Redskins will take the snap from the 35. Jason Witten with the grab. That's a pickup of 14.
Nice job that time, but the tight end makes the catch, and you got to look out for him now in the NFL. Remember, they're usually the closest receiver to the quarterback. Quarterback gets in trouble, he's going to look for the tight end.
Corners are backing off here. An extra tight end on the field for this one. Three-step drop. The Redskins get a first down. And he's tackled, but not until he picked up the first down.
The slant route made famous by the West Coast offense, something that really I thought came in the league when Bill Walsh started with the 49ers in 1979.
Now first and 10. Chiefs on the receiving end. You knew this was going to happen, and the coach disagrees with the call on the field. So the coach is challenged back.
Fires, they'll lose the timeout, and they fail to overturn the call on the field.
You know what you do in situations like this? You fire the guy upstairs who told him, throw the flag, coach. Well, what do you got to say now? It was a terrible call, terrible decision, and you lose a timeout.
Second down and 7. And incomplete as Witten can't hold on.
Good job that time by the secondary. They're in good position. They make the play, and it's an incomplete pass by the quarterback.
The Redskins now on third down. Just a week ago, they converted at a high rate in third down situations. Third and 7. Looking across the middle. What a first series. Touchdown. That's a terrific start for this team, Phil, with the early touchdown.
Yeah, just the way they planned it. Man, you get in there during the week, you practice, you look at all that film, and then you say, here's going to be our starting plays for the game. You go out there, you run up, and you score. That is a great feeling.
And they're all over him at the 18-yard line. First down at the 18. Looking long. What a catch.
There's just so few quarterbacks who know how to throw it high and far anymore. Nice job that time by the quarterback. That throw was right on the money.
First down here after the completion. And they get the sack.
What a good scheme that time by the defense. They confuse the offense. They blitz. They don't know who to pick up. And how about the defender? They must love this. Coming in free and gets a good clean shot on the QB and gets a sack.
The Redskins' defense now is going to go nickel. Over to Greg Olsen with the reception. And now they'll be on the other side of the 50 after this play.
Now, if you want to keep your place on the offense, then catch the pass and break a tackle and get some extra yards. That's what the guy did on that play. Nice job by him.
Coming to the line at the 45. Third and short. Tannehill gives it up. Hill's tackled down at the 38.
Well, one of the hardest things to do, and I think in the NFL now, is third shortest run the football and pick up yards. That time, nice job by the offensive line. They showed their power, and they picked up the first down.
First down and 10. Hills handed the football. Williams all over that offense and brings him down.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
It's Tannehill out of the pistol. Second down and a long way to go. He climbs the ladder and has it. Incredible catch there by the receiver as he goes vertical and comes down with the football and the catch.
We see these incredible catches every single week. Right now, the most talented guys in the NFL might be the wide receivers. They can just do everything. Run, jump, run routes, and make these incredible catches.
And that's a big tackle behind the line of scrimmage. Here they come to the line at the 23. Michael Rivera with the reception. Now that we've got a moment, let's look at the Rams offense. Last week, they never turned the football over once. The Rams have driven inside the red zone, and last week they were so effective inside the 20. Third and 12. It's caught by Jerron Brown. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
You know, as a quarterback, sometimes you got to trust that arm and throw the football past the first down marker. There were guys open, but no, he takes the safe route, throws it short, defense makes the tackle, and here we are staring at a fourth down.
As we edge closer to the second quarter, they edge a little closer on the scoreboard with the successful kick.
Yeah, that was good for the team. It was a big confidence boost, and now they know they can do it on the offensive side. And now it's up to the defense to keep this thing going.
The Redskins offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. A solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, what a productive day so far for the offense. They're mixing it up well. They got confidence. The quarterback's throwing it well. This is a very good game so far.
That's a gain of 7.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Foster in the backfield, single back set. The Redskins will take the snap from the 25. Foster tackled down, but the play picked up 8.
What a good job by the running back that time. He reads the box very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice.
First and 10. Back to the ground. Foster's tackled down after a gain of 7.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done. Look at the signals. The D-line is all shifting down inside. They're expecting to run right at the middle.
He's averaging right around 7 yards per carry on the game.
Foster's a great running back to have on your football team, isn't he? He goes up in there and gets the first down. Now your offense has 3 more chances.
Defense respecting the deep ball, playing way off the receivers. Foster in the backfield, single back set. Foster takes it on the toss. And this run goes backwards and will end up as a loss of 5. Back here in the second quarter, defense ruled the first. And what are we going to see here, you think, in the second quarter, Phil?
Well, I think the first thing they got to do, Jim, is just believe in what they did all week long and preparing for the game. All the practices, all the film sessions, and just know sometimes it takes more than one quarter to get the answer. So stay with your game plan and see if you can find a way to make it work.
The second quarter is underway with this snap.
going for the home run,
but it's incomplete.
Deep passes in the NFL, they always serve a purpose. You're not always going to get the completion, but at least it gets the defense thinking that you will try some long throws down the field.
Third down. No bump coverage here. Corners backing up. Foster's lined up in a single back formation. Knocked down as he fires it.
The Redskins put themselves in a situation where the defense has all the advantage. They know the pass probably has to go down the field on third and long, and they were ready for it.
Touchback here. We'll bring the ball out to the 20. The Rams offense is set to take over once again. They moved the ball well last time. Right down the field they went, but they could not get it into the end zone, winding up with only a field goal.
Yeah, but their confidence has got to be high. All the good things they did. We saw some good passing, some good running, good offensive line play. I like where this offense is at right now.
Airing it out. Snags it right out of the air with one hand.
Olsen's going back to the huddle, and he's telling everybody, look up at the Jumbotron, and let's watch a replay of me making that spectacular catch.
Tannehill's completed his last six passes. Hill takes his spot in the backfield. They're going back up top. Greg Olsen has the catch. Olsen's met after a gain of eight. Third catch today so far.
Rams did a good job there on first down. That pass picks up some good solid yards. Now second and short. Much easier to call those kind of plays.
Tannehill's 7 for 7 with that completion. Second and two. Jeremy Hill has the catch. This is third down. Hill's going to secure the handoff. He's got some daylight.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
The offense coming to the line inside the opponent's 20. Bradshaw, solo back set. First and 10. Here's the handoff to Ahmad Bradshaw. They bring him to the turf. Second down coming up. The Redskins defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Tannehill's going to slide and avoid the hit.
It's a rough game out there. Avoid hits at all costs. Good job that time by the quarterback sliding before he takes the hit.
Third down on the way. Defense ready in the goal line formation on this one. That timeout by the offense. It's third down coming up. Hill's going to take the handoff now. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down.
Games in the NFL can hinge on third and short. Who can pick them up and who can stop them? How about that play that time by the defense? They stopped the third and short run, and now it's fourth down.
Drives it through for the field goal.
Phil, I know they were looking for a touchdown on that drive, but they at least put up three midway through the second quarter.
Well, you know, that three, maybe that 3 points is going to be the difference in this game. That's how you have to look at it when you score. Don't always look at the negative. Sometimes look at the positive, and I think that three was very important.
And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21.
The Redskins stalled on their last drive, forced a punt. So now the offense comes back out onto the field.
Yeah, they're coming back out. They lack confidence, and I understand why. They came out, couldn't get anything done. The defense was flying around making the plays. They got to change the tempo of this game.
The Redskins come to the line in a tight game here in the second quarter. The score's 7-6. First down at the 21. Over to Witten with the reception.
Redskins did a good job that time throwing a pass on first down and picked up some nice yards. Now second and short really puts the defense in a tough position.
Pass complete, but did not get them the first, so it's second down now. Arian Foster lined up in the backfield. And Arian Foster has the catch. Third down now. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Bridgewater's got it in the gun. Holmes hauls it in. That's a gain of 8. That's his first reception today.
The key to being a really good route runner and running these drag routes across the field is show some courage. Don't worry about what's in front of you. The quarterback will take care of that.
Bridgewater's completion percentage 70% on the day. The Redskins from the 37. Got hit on release. Failing to complete that one. So second down here. Bridgewater's back in shotgun formation. He's drilled as he throws.
Sometimes on third and long from the defensive side, I like the fact that you can blitz. Send more guys than they can block. Make the quarterback throw the football quickly and short. Then it's all up to coming up and making the tackle. Now he's going to change the play. Look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
Third down and 10. The ball is charged loose.
So many times when you drop a football in the NFL, a pass like that, it's because of lack of concentration. You're just not serious about what you're doing.
He's got a chance to return this one. They bring him down at the 29-yard line.
The Rams love this type of play. Of course, everybody would. When you get a good punt return, that's what you want. And, of course, it helps when you have an explosive punt returner back there.
Hill in the backfield. Single back set. The Rams have it at the 29. And a flag comes out. And incomplete. What a hit that time. The defense accepts the penalty. Press coverage all the way. Quarters formation here for the defense. First down at the 19. Complete as Olsen can't hold on.
Sometimes when you have a player with this kind of talent, you're willing to put up with a few drop passes because when he catches it, he has a chance of going all the way.
Second down coming up. Tannehill from the gun. Going for the deep ball. He's able to come down with it. What a catch. One-handed.
Brown's got a pair of grippers, and of course by that I mean hands. They are big, they are strong, and you need those to make that one-handed catch.
Tannehill's completion percentage, 90% on the day. And we've reached the two-minute warning. Looks like they're in press coverage here. The Rams line up in the pistol offense. The Rams have it at the 44. Olsen's got it on a pass that had some heat. Hill takes his spot in the backfield. Now first and 10. Scans the field. The Rams put up six. Browns caught his first touchdown of the season.
What a throw by the quarterback for a touchdown. It was just really nice. He threw it beautifully right on target. Touchdown.
The Rams line up for the extra point. The extra point is good. The Redskins ready to return the kick. Redskins didn't get much out of that last drive, so now here they come again on offense. I'm sure they're going to be a little bit more of an urgency to the offense this time.
Well, I'll just say this to you, Jim Nance. I sure hope so. After that last drive, that was just too generic. Wasn't very well thought out, but they got to change what they're doing on the offensive side.
Got to give that defense a little credit, though, don't you?
Well, yeah, the defense did its job, but it was pretty easy. Good job by the offense going the hurry-up offense. You do this to get the plays in, but also you want to conserve the timeouts.
And that's a gain of 10.
Situations you go over so many times in practice and training camp. Know what's going on the offensive side, how to preserve time. Good job that time by the offensive player. Get out of bounds and give his team more chances to get it done here in the first half.
Bridgewater's completion percentage, 60% on the day. First down and 10. Sanu makes the grab. Denard's in on the tackle. The Redskins trail here in the first half, Bill, but you can't say there aren't some positives here. Bridgewater's doing what he can to keep them in the game.
Well, they are losing, but you cannot blame the offense. The offensive line doing a good job giving the quarterback time, and the offensive coordinator, he's sitting over there going, he doesn't know which play to call because everything is working in the passing game.
A line of scrimmage is the 26-yard line. The corner step back. Second down and 10. And Holmes is going to pull in the bullet pass.
Do the little things right. When you do those right, you get big victories. And doing it right is what this offensive player did that time. Had a chance to get out of bounds, stop the clock, give his offense more chances. Really good job by the offensive player.
Stepping up, ready to go from the 7. First and goal from the 7. Has is his target. Redskins in for the score. Bridgewater's now got 5 touchdown passes on the season. The point after is good. The Rams are ready to return the kick. He'll take it from the 1. The Rams offense preparing to get this drive underway. The last possession ended in a touchdown. Phil, let's see if they can do it again.
Very well done. Love what I saw out there on the offense the last time. They mixed it up and they showed a lot of confidence. You can see the speed of the football team and try to duplicate what they just did. Good job by the defensive line shifting all down inside. I think they're expecting a run up the middle.
First down at the 21. Down the field. The defender able to knock it away.
That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position. Nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football. And it leads to another incomplete pass.
Second down after the incompletion. Hills lined up directly behind the quarterback here. And it's batted down.
Well, there's no doubt what to do in a situation like this. You do not take a chance and put your team in a position where they have to make a big comeback in the second half.
Tannehill's lined up. 2 tight ends set. Third and 10. And now Tannehill's going to take off. That ball should have been picked, but instead it's knocked away incomplete.
Tannehill's athletic enough to get out of the pocket. That's a really good job by him. But you have to give the defense a lot of credit. They shut down all the receivers. About that punt return? Well, he didn't fumble the football.
The Redskins offense preparing to get this drive underway. Their last drive actually ended in a touchdown, Phil. We'll see if they still have it in them to issue a repeat performance.
Well, what you saw in that last drive was everything just came together perfectly for him. The experience of the football team, the talent of the players, and the coaches helped them out and got it done.
Holmes makes the catch.
Good job that time by the ball carrier, picking up what he can, and he's very smart. Gets out of bounds and stops the clock.
The corner's retreating. First down at the 40. Throws the pass.
Oh, it almost picked off that time.
When you're going against a good quarterback and receiver in the NFL now, one of the ways to stop it is tight man-to-man coverage. You against him.
One more snap, and we'll head to halftime. Jarring hit that time. Knocks the ball free.
Well, but it's third and long. I'll just say this. Be very careful on the offensive side.
It'll be third down. The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. The defender tips it out. That'll do it for the first half here, just outside our nation's capital. We'll take a short breather for halftime and return in a moment for the second half. And he'll start his return. The Rams offense comes back onto the field. Let's see if they can move the chains this time, because the last possession was ugly. They weren't out there very long.
Jim, you know how I think in situations like this, I think it's more up to the coach than the players. Call a play that really catches the defense off guard so you can get an easy gain and get the momentum on your side and get it rolling.
Ryan Tannehill will be under center. The Rams from the 32. Flip to the outside. Jenkins, the one who made the big stop.
Got to give the defense some credit. On first down, there's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped.
And now they'll try over again on second down. The Redskins lined up in the nickel. And it's knocked down.
Now, careful, you can throw that out the window. Now it's time to be aggressive, take a chance, and put the defense on edge. Can you do that and give your team a chance to still win this game?
On the way, third down. The Rams need to get to the 42 for the first down.
Look out, they're changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
Third down and 13. He'll throw it over the middle. And by Kerrigan this time.
The Rams just picked up a big first down that time, Jim. When you're down in the second half, every first down is crucial. Nice job that time by the offense.
Tannehill's completion percentage, 70% on the day. First and 10. And he's taken down.
A lot of things to look at if you're a quarterback in this league now, isn't it? You look at safeties, you look at linebackers, but you forget, hey, these corners can blitz. Good disguise, good timing, and a nice sack by the corner.
The Rams have it at the 39. He's going to be swallowed up behind the line.
Redskins guessed right on the defensive side that time. They thought it was going to be a run play. They were all over it, and they got in the backfield and made the tackle.
Looking at third down. The Rams need to get to the 42 for the first down. From the gun, Tannehill. A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one.
Well, it's in the second half. It's fourth and short near midfield, and you are losing the game. And I think this is a decision. The odds are in your favor. I think you go for it here, and if you don't get it, you can still survive and let your defense do some work for you.
The Rams will go for it here on fourth down and a short yardage situation. It's Tannehill out of the pistol. The Rams will use a timeout here early in the second half. The Rams will go for it here on fourth down and short. Hill takes his spot in the backfield. The Rams take it from the 43. The Rams turn the ball over on downs. What did you think of that decision here, Phil, in the third quarter to go for it on fourth down?
Oh, let me think. I hated it. How's that? It doesn't take me long. You don't have to think long and hard about that decision. Just something I would not do in this point of the game. Midway in the third, no use taking a chance like that. That was awful. D-line is shifting inside. They're pinching. I think they're expecting a run up the middle.
Andre Holmes with the reception. Denard's going to make the tackle. We'll go no huddle. Second down and 5. And the quarterback gives it to Arian Foster. Breaks free. Impressive piece of running by Arian Foster.
Keep the momentum on your side. You got a lead here in the second half. Nice play that time. You pick up the first down. Let's see if you can take advantage of it. The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
First and goal. Witten's makes the catch. Touchdown.
Well, when you get close to the goal line, you always have to look out for the tight end, because anytime there's just a little bit of deception, That deception is enough for the tight end to get that area where he can get open. That time he does it, touchdown.
Webb's got it. And he's taken down right at about the 29, not quite to the 30.
The Rams on offense, you'll remember the last time they were on the field, they faced that decision in opponent's territory and opted to go for it instead of kicking the field goal.
Yeah, I would think they're pretty motivated coming back out in the field, especially since they got nothing out of that last drive. I agree with the decision to go for it on fourth down. They just need better execution from the offensive player.
Kerrigan with the sack.
Nice job that time for the outside linebacker getting the sack. They ask a lot of these guys now. They are special players in the NFL, stopping the run and the speed to get outside and get the sacks on the quarterback too.
Hills lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback. Has Olsen. That's his sixth catch of the day. The Rams still trail, but as we look at the passing numbers, it's hard to find much fault with them. Tannehill's tried to keep his team in it any way he can.
Well, a couple things, Jim. You can't blame the quarterback because of trailing. He has been outstanding here today. The offense, the offensive line, the play calling, all good.
Have decided now to go for it on fourth down and a short yardage situation. Tannehill with the surge.
The Rams look pretty confident out there on the field, don't they? And they're very calm, and they should be. That first down, they're right in this game. Don't look down the field for that big play. Just keep marching.
They're able to move the chains after that last run. Finds his mark. That's a gain of six.
Well, when you keep chipping away with these short throws, sooner or later that defense is going to come up. And when they come up, that's when you throw it over the top.
Tannehill's now completed four in a row. Second down, four to go. Complete to Greg Olsen.
Big first down by the offense that time. Here in the second half, they're losing a close game, and you get that first down, it just gives you confidence, it opens up the playbook, and it just gives you a better chance of going down the field and getting the score.
The Rams will take the snap from the 35. Slashes to the left side.
If you want to run the football with success, you're going to have plays like this where they pick up very little yardage. Don't listen to the fans. Keep running it, and it'll work.
The Rams take it from the 33. Ball is out. Tackle's made. What a lucky break this time. They fumble, but they recover it and maintain possession.
NFL teams, the offense, every single day they work with anybody that's going to handle the football. How to hold it, he didn't do a good job that time. That's why he fumbled.
The Rams offense has switched sides now and has the football as we begin the fourth quarter. At after very nearly giving the football away, they now face a third and 11.
When you see linebackers moving like this, they're trying to confuse the offensive line.
Looking across the middle, Hill with the reception.
Defense did a good job that time. It's third long. They know the offense wants to throw down the field. They cover all the deep receivers and nowhere to go with the football except short.
They bring back out the offense to go for it. That's going to be a timeout charged to the offense. Going for it on fourth down. Double tight end formation. The Rams snap it up at the 26. Running room. Taking it all the way home for the touchdown. That's an important touchdown for this resilient bunch that just never quits, never believes it's out of a game, Phil.
That's what it takes, Jim. In situations like this, you just have to be tougher than your opponent, and that's what they showed there, getting that touchdown. Now we are going to have a contest down here in the fourth quarter.
They failed to convert on the two-point try, so they'll just have to settle for the six. The Redskins ready to return the kick. He'll have a chance to take off. And the tackle's made right around the 26-yard line. The Redskins now ready to take over again on offense. They were successful on their previous drive, getting the ball all the way to the end zone. I'm sure they're looking for more of the same right now.
Oh, absolutely. That's what you always want. You want to find your way to the end zone. And so many people contributed on that last drive, and you've got to give the coaches a lot of credit for putting the players in excellent position.
Foster, and he gains maybe three.
That was a predictable play call here in the fourth quarter. You got a little lead, and you're trying to run the football to run out the clock, but the defense was ready and stopped it for a short game.
Two tight ends on the field here. Here's the handoff, and they'll run it.
The Redskins running back that time, he makes a bad decision. You can't be looking to make every play a big play when you're running the football. Look for a few yards, take advantage of that. He tries for the big play. What happens? He gets tackled for a loss.
Playing press coverage to the outside. The Redskins take it from the 28. Throws the pass. And it's spotted away.
Aggressive call by the defense. They stopped the offense. Now they got them in fourth down. And let's see if their offense can come out and maybe win the game here late in the fourth quarter.
Fields will be called on now to punt the football. Fields it cleanly and starts his return. And a run back of about four. The Rams offense coming back onto the field. It was a good drive for them last time they had it, all the way down to the end zone for the touchdown.
Yeah, you know, in this game, Jim, it's all about momentum. And when you feel you've got the momentum on your side, you've got to take advantage of it. So now I think it's up to the offensive coordinator to call the right plays.
Press coverage all the way. First down at the 33. And he's going to pitch it here. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
Running backs in the NFL now, it's hard to bring them down. That time, nice job of breaking a tackle.
They went with the ground game on first down, bringing up second. Dropping back three. Damon Harrison behind the line and gets to the quarterback.
Defensive tackles, we always think of them as run stoppers. How about this that time? He does a great job, gets in there, and sacks the quarterback.
Third down. Stiff arms to stay on his feet. And he's going to be dropped for the sack. And they're going to be punting after a short series. The Rams call on their punting team. He'll have a chance for a return. Gets about 9 on the play.
The Redskins weren't able to get anything out of their last drive and were forced to punt. As they take the field here, do you think they are going to vary their approach, Phil?
Well, I hope so. I think they will. They got a lot of information out there in that short drive, Jim, and you do that by showing different formations and plays. You saw how the defense reacted to it. Now you counter-react and see if you can get some positive plays.
I'm sure they're tired of being in the three-and-out business.
Well, that's a bad business to be in. I know. I get in a lot of bad businesses.
That last running play was good for only a yard, so it's 2nd down and 9. Play clock's running down to the ground. Foster tackled down, this time for 8.
Always good to have these types of runs. Hey, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to, and also it opens up so many other things for your offense.
The Redskins have it at the 44. Foster is tackled down after a gain of 5.
Redskins offense, they know it's more than just about their defense. The offense did a good job that time picking up the first down. That's what you want to do. You got a small lead in the second half. Keep getting those first downs and eat that clock up.
They come to the line, and it's first down. Leading and with possession of the football, a good place to be at this point in the game. The clock's really become a factor here, and the defense knows it has to get off the field as soon as possible to give the team a chance. First down at the 49. Foster's tackled down at the 50. 2 minutes to go in the second half. We'll set up now at midfield. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. 2nd down and 8. And the quarterback gives it to Arian Foster. This is 3rd down. Corners are backing off here. The Redskins have to get to the 41 for a first. Bridgewater's going to take the snap from the shotgun. And over to Witten. 6th catch today so far.
They know if they give up the first down, the game is probably over. They get fooled and they give it up. Probably why they're going to lose.
The Redskins had to put last week's heart-wrenching loss behind them, and they've done that so far, although they've got another game that might be coming down to the wire.
Yes, they do, Jim, right now. But what did you learn from last week's defeat? Can that be the difference to get you through and win this game today?
The offense heads to the line for the 7th play of the drive. Is every win sweet, or are the close ones that much more satisfying than just blowing someone out for 60 minutes?
Well, the close ones are more satisfying because the tension is there longer. And the longer you're under tension, when it finally comes to...